With just 3 days to go for the launch of the OnePlus 60, there is not much waiting. However, there is a lot that we know about the 60 right now, and here is all of that. Hi guys, this is Krithin Kalra for AndroGuider, and today we will be telling you everything that we know about the OnePlus 60. Let's start with the design. As many of you would know, OnePlus and Oppo share the same parent company, and that is BBK Electronics. So it shouldn't come as a surprise that the OnePlus 60 will be having a design similar to the Oppo R17 that was announced just a few months back. The R17 has a water drop notch, and leaks suggest that the 60 will be having the same notch. In comparison, the notch on the OnePlus 6 covered nearly one third of the top of the screen. A smaller notch here means more screen real estate and more notification icons in the status bar. I'm looking at you, Poco. However, there is a con to the smaller notch too. When I zoom in, you can see that the earpiece has been squished to the top and it's really tiny. I'm just afraid that it might not sound as good as the one on the OnePlus 6. But let's just hope that OnePlus has looked after that. Moving to the back, we have the vertically aligned camera setup as seen on the OnePlus 6. The 60 is expected to sport the same camera hardware as on its predecessor, and that includes a 16 megapixel primary shooter with f1.7 aperture and 1.22 micron pixel size. The secondary shooter here is a Sony IMX376K with 20 megapixels of resolution, f1.7 aperture and 1 micron pixel size. When you look below the camera, that's where things seem to be out of place. There is no fingerprint scanner. So did OnePlus ditch the fingerprint scanner? Well, no, but they did ditch the headphone jack. Anyway, we'll get to the headphone jack part in a second. The OnePlus 60 will be having an in-display fingerprint scanner, and it will be an optical sensor. Now, there are two types of fingerprint scanners. One is optical and the other type is ultrasonic. In theory, the optical sensors are slower than ultrasonic. So does that mean the fingerprint scanner on the OnePlus 60 will, or inside the OnePlus 60 will be slower? Well, OnePlus phones have been known in the past for their super fast unlock speeds. So I just hope that OnePlus would have figured something out here and they would have somehow managed to boost the speed of the fingerprint scanner. Next, as I have told you, the 60 won't be having the headphone jack. Now you might ask, well, OnePlus, why did you remove the headphone jack? And to that, OnePlus has said that it feels now is the right time. Here is exactly what OnePlus co-founder Carl Pei said about this, and I quote, "We are not doing it for the sake of doing it and because everyone else is. We believe now is the right time as it will benefit the majority of our users while keeping the downside low." The irony here is that OnePlus calls itself an enthusiast brand, and according to the Twitter polls that you are seeing, apparently, the enthusiasts don't want the jack to be dropped. Anyway, there's actually not much we can do about this rather than complain about it. OnePlus has launched the Type-C version of its Bullets earphones. So if you do want a OnePlus branded set of earphones, then check these out. I'll be having the requisite links in the description below. And mind you, these are wired earphones. If you are looking for wireless earphones from OnePlus, then Bullets Wireless are there. I forgot to mention that just like the removal of the 3.5mm jack, the in-display fingerprint scanner is also an official confirmation. Another thing that has been confirmed by OnePlus is that the 60 won't be having any IP certification or wireless charging. For the IP rating part, in a teardown video of the OnePlus 6, Zach Nelson, aka Jerry Rig Everything, said, in fact, wait a minute, I will let him speak.
Water resistance of this OnePlus 6 is on par with other flagships that actually do have an IP rating. Every hole seems to be protected. There is even an additional screen over the loudspeaker holes, so there are some ingress points that have even doubled up on water protection. I'll get the charging port screwed back into place. I personally would never risk my electronics around water, and I'm not exactly sure why OnePlus didn't get an official IP rating for the phone. But from the inside, it looks like this OnePlus 6 has all of the same protections that other IP67 phones have.
On top of that, OnePlus CEO Pete Law said in a recent interview that the OnePlus 60 would be more water resistant than previous OnePlus phones. That's why I am not too worried about the dust and water resistance rating. Moving along, OnePlus will be further expanding into the American and European markets with the 6T. There is a rumor that OnePlus will be partnering with T-Mobile for carrier availability in the United States. And earlier today, there was a report that claimed that the 6T had cleared Verizon certification. OnePlus has also confirmed that the 6T will be sold at O2, EE, Vodafone, John Lewis and Carphone Warehouse in the United Kingdom. Two more things. OnePlus will be opening an office in the Netherlands and a retail store in Paris. So clearly, OnePlus is focused on expanding its footprint in Europe. We also have the pricing details. The 6T will be available in three configurations. 6128 at €559, that is $640 or 47,000 Indian rupees. The 8128GB model will be priced at €589 and that is $670 or 49,000 Indian rupees. And finally, the 8256GB variant will cost you a whopping €639 and that translates to $730 or about 53,000 Indian rupees. The base model of the OnePlus 6 costs €469 and that of the 6T costs €559. So this is quite a price increase. In fact, I guess this is the biggest price jump that OnePlus has made between its phones. Alright, so let's just hope that OnePlus 6T does turn out to be good. And we also have the complete specification sheet for the OnePlus 6T, and here it is. I will give you guys some time to have a look at it. And that's about it, guys. The OnePlus 6T launches on the October 29th. The launch event will be live streamed. And if you want to know more about that, check out the blog post linked in the description box. And of course, we will be covering the event on our blog. And I'll also make sure that we do a launch summary video for the event, just like we did for the launch event of the OnePlus 6. To get alerted about that video, make sure you are subscribed and like this video if you liked it. I hope that made sense. Yeah, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Sayonara.